Hi, my name is Emily Erickson, and I'm the Director of Member Services at Brandon Credit Union. Today I'm here to talk to you about an issue which you reported at the last board meeting. You stated that there's been an increase in fees received from return checks, insufficient funds, and early withdrawals from CDs among our clients, especially in the last 3 years. This is a problem which we need to address for a couple of key reasons. First, our customers really don't like paying all these fees. Now, the fees that we're charging them, they are fair and they're actually less than those that would be charged by a bank. However, there's a notion in the public that credit unions charge lower fees than banks. On their services which they offer, and all these people who are signing up for accounts are being charged fees which they think are unfair. And even though we are, just charging standard fees, we're losing customer rapport because customers don't know what they're signing up for and committing to upon opening an account at our institution. Second, Branton Credit Union is actually making money from the fees which it's charging. However, there's less money that people have in paying these fees to put into savings accounts, which average a higher rate of return than the fees themselves for our institution. And so we don't want people paying these fees at the expense of not putting their money in these other savings programs and investment programs, which actually bring in more income to our credit union. So for these reasons, I spent a lot of time working with my department looking at the problem, and specifically why it's escalated over the past 3 years. So looking at our data and kind of what's changed with our credit union in the past 3 years, I observed a pattern. I noticed that five of the new branches which we opened, we have 20 branches currently, but five of the new ones we opened, and then 12 of the new kiosks which we just placed were actually on college campuses. And if we look at the data, it's actually these college-age students who are having issues with overdraft and with withdrawing early from their CDs. It's not our older members or people who have been doing business with our credit union for longer periods of time. So because of this, I think the most or the best way to proceed is with a program in educating these new members of our credit union about the services that we offer and also responsible personal finance habits. And so that's what I wanted to talk to you guys about today, is more how we can go about instituting such an educational program. And again, these ideas come from working with my department. So the first idea that we had as a department was starting a partnership with the colleges. Colleges are one of the ways which students get experience with professional development. A lot of college campuses have financial literacy departments or programs or pre-existing initiatives. And we have an opportunity as Branton Credit Union to come in and have a partnership with one of these programs or the ones where our credit unions exist to talk about financial literacy and to talk about our services with the students. So for this, we would want to work with the teachers to include a curriculum on the different types of financial institutions. So we want students, to have a broad understanding of different financial institutions. So basically depository institutions like different types of banks, and also non-depository institutions like brokerage firms and insurance firms, and the services they offer. So loans, checking, savings, certificate of deposit, all those different services, just so that these students can go out into the world and be educated in making financial decisions. And then also to, promote our own services as a credit union and what the difference between a credit union and a bank is and things like that. It's also important that students understand the Federal Reserve, especially how it regulates the money supply in the country, and sets interest rates among banks, and loaning each other money. And also the FDIC, the $250,000 of insured assets that are provided in accounts that are covered or FDIC approved or insured. And then also with regards to our credit union specifically, the National Credit Union Association and how that provides us coverage. as opposed to the FDIC being more relegated to the realm of banks. Sponsoring such programs will introduce students to our programs, our loans, our savings options, opening accounts, and further broaden our customer base. So having such a partnership would be really strategic on our ends. Beyond schools, institution-wise, we could also do a better job educating these new clients by providing them information sheets when they sign up, having brochures available at all of our branch locations, and then giving them information in a newsletter. We need to discuss how certificate of deposits work, that people are putting money in for a set amount of time and they can't take it out before that in order to reap the higher interest rates, or else they would just be in a normal savings account. So we need to discuss how those work so people know that they can't take out money. Also, overdraft, return checks, insufficient funds, letting people know that they can't, take money out of their account that isn't there, and encouraging programs such as our low balance alert program, and then also opting out of overdraft protection so that these fees never have a chance to occur. Finally, we need to encourage students to use tracking software. In the past, people would use check registers to track how much money was in their account. But nowadays, students aren't using checks, they're using debit cards. And so having an app on their phone that keeps track of their account balance and then the money that they're spending and using out of that, talking about those and providing information in newsletters and in pamphlets and brochures and information when they sign up for the accounts, that would really help to address the problem. So as a board, do you have any questions on these suggestions or further research we can do?
I like what you've talked about today, so thank you.
Thank you.